Well, today I have a good, expensive Sanyo cassette deck, and I bet it has no line fuse in it for overcurrent protection, and as you can see, it is UL listed. Okay, so I'll take the top off and we'll look and see if this has a fuse in it for overcurrent protection. And no, it does not have any overcurrent protection. As you can see, the power comes in, goes to the cord, straight up to the transformer. So I'm going to put a fuse block up here on the back, and we are going to put one in. So I'll drill the hole right here. Okay, we'll separate these two wires here from the cord. We'll take our fuse block here. We'll get a piece of sandpaper out. This is sandpaper for metal, so this would be perfect to use for this. So sand the inside. Down just a little bit so I get a better sand in there. Side looks good. I'll bend this one down a little bit. Okay, so put our block in our thing here. Okay, so we'll put our tail on here to go back to the power transformer. The other one I did a twist and loop. This one I'm going to just fold it over and squeeze it down and see how that works. I'm going to use my rosin flux. By the way, I made this little fixture here out of a battery clip and a L bracket and a piece of a 2x4. So I'll turn this so you can see it here. Put a little flux here on the top, a little bit on the bottom. My 4060 solder. So let's see how this works. I'm going to put a little tin on my iron here. Well, that came out pretty nice. I'm going to let that cool a bit and turn it over and I'll do the other side. Good, I got a nice flow through on this side. So I'll take the one off the power transformer here. Grab and get all our little strands off of here. Tin my iron a bit. Grab, make sure I get all the strands in there. Okay, now I'll strip this here. I'll tin this wire here. I'll twist my strands together nice and tight. Get into the flux. And I'll tin it. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll make a little loop here. I'll go into the fuse block here. I'll flatten the loop down on the other side here. I'm going to have to turn my little jig here and hold it up like that. I want it all nice and straight. Okay, and I'll get some flux in here, a little on the top and a little bit underneath on the bottom here, because I want to make sure I get a real nice flow. Okay, I'm going to use the thinner solder. Okay, I'm going to clean my tip again. I'm going to tin it a little bit here, come underneath. I'll let that cool a bit. Okay, now look at the back side. I got a nice clean solder joint there on the back. But I got some copper there a little bit exposed, so I'm going to reheat that and push that down. There we go, it's nice. Now there's a little bit of a cold spot there, so what I'm going to do is just take a little flux, and I'm going to just flux that, and I'll put a little flux here on the bottom, and I'll just put a very little tin on my iron here, and I'll just reheat it, the whole thing. There, now it's a nice, even, clean solder joint. I'll just let that cool a bit. Strip this end. I'm going to take it out of here and I'm going to see what this looks like. Okay, so I'm going to set this here. And this is going to come around. So I'm going to cut some of this off here. I'm going to strip a little bit more off. Okay, so now I'm going to wrap these strands around here. Okay, see that solder there? I'm going to use my pump and I'm going to pump that off. This is a very handy thing to have. This is a solder pump. And I'm going to just pick up all this excess solder over here on the top of the transformer. There. Okay, so now I can get this wire down on the post, wrap it around, make sure all my strands are wrapped in tight. I'll take these wide pliers here and I'll squeeze them all together. And now we're ready to solder it. So I'll take and put just a little bit of flux on here. I'll clean my iron again so I get a nice clean solder joint. Tin it. There we go, we got a real nice clean solder joint. I'm gonna just let that cool a bit. I'm gonna just tin my iron now that I'm done with it, and I'm gonna shut it off. Okay, I wanna show you why I put the fuse in these units. See how small the filament is inside of this little fuse I'm putting in the tape deck? And here are your typical house fuses. Okay, so see these rectifier diodes here and the power capacitors? If these power capacitors or these diodes shorted out, it can overheat the transformer, and if the transformer gets hot and shorts out, it can start drawing current on the line cord, and this wire for the cord is not rated for 20 amps, so while it's taking time to burn a house fuse, it can melt the cord and possibly start a fire in your house. I'm going to put this fuse in a better place because I don't want it to be too close to the top there, so I'm going to just pop this little cover off for the switch. I can unscrew this. So there's all of them, so I can drill through. Through all the way, and I'll take, where'd my screw go? Here it is. there. And through here. So I'm going to have a longer one. Yeah, I'm going to mount the fuse block on this here. This is a good place to mount it. It's Alrighty, so now we can get this all back into place here. I'll put all three of my wires back through the channel here that they were in. I just want to make sure they're not going to be under that screw. I want to make sure they're along the side of it so that they don't get punctured. Okay, so everything is all where it should be. You know what would be really nice if I knew where I put it? When I set something down, I wish I could find it. Oh, here it is. Can put our switch back on here. And we'll take our alcohol and Q-tips and clean our solder joints up. Okay, so now we'll put our half amp fuse in, and now this unit has overcurrent protection that the UL, the Consumer Product Safety Commission, and the manufacturer should have required in the first place. Thanks for watching.